you know, stuff for, you know, these women are bringing you all like these little sandwiches and stuff, you don't eat enough, and she's like, they're like grabbing cheeks.
Sounds
and
like grandma. All that, that's grandma.
You need to plump up. And you know, you get the one that's like fixing Steve's hair, and one that's like straightening up Omen's jacket and all this, and they're like brushing you off and all that, so you guys head out. Okay, so the roll. All right. Okay, so halfway, your roll gives me this. All right, so you see to the north, you don't have any kind of sensors or anything on the vehicle. You are getting you come into range of what is probably a short range beacon of some kind. Mm-hmm. It's only a radio beacon. Mm-hmm. It's not giving any information at all. It's just a beep. It's just beeping. Mm-hmm. It could be there's no telling what it could be. I mean, it could be emergency. It could be, almost like a cell phone tower kind of thing. I mean, it's curious. It's curious that it's out here in the middle of nowhere. But your radio, so you guys took the track vehicle. So the track vehicle is picking up, something, and it's probably maybe 20 clicks off the beaten path that you're sort of triangulating it off north. So probably like up here someplace.
Yep.
It's as you move towards the middle here. So as you're kind of coming from what is that? Okay. MS2. Yeah. So as you're kind of coming in. My text back. So as you're getting about halfway, the radio signal starts to get stronger, and it gets the strongest when you kind of get about this bend in the road. You assume the closer you get to Zamble Chevrolet, the more it'll begin to go out. But if you zoom in, like I said, probably maybe at the end of this. At the end of these area here, probably to the next little clump of trees. Mm-hmm. Actually, it's a bit further. Let's see. It's not quite that far. Not quite 30 kilometers, but it's maybe about 20 kilometers. So, off road, maybe a half hour. With the speed that your vehicle goes off road. And it's just a beep 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 beep.
It's okay, a warning. On.
It could be. What do you guys want to do?
Is there anything we can do, like a computer scan?
If you have that equipment.
I did. I was in the process of... I have a hand computer, and I've got a computer, too.
Okay. So out here, all the planets have GINs, which are your global information networks. Basically, that's like the equivalent of the internet, pretty much. Not anymore. So like, if you've got what's the equivalent of like a smartphone or whatever, you're not getting any bars anymore. You know what I mean? So access to the global information network is
probably only in the cities, hey?
Yeah, it's sort of faded out when you there was a little bit there was probably some hardline uplinks in the Kolkhozy, but there's nothing out here.
Yeah.
Okay, well, I'm pulling out my binoculars, got my combi goggles on. Just trying to, no one else has got tactics, have they?
No.
Got my head out the top.
Browsing computer, recruiting, rifleman. I got Jack O.T. though. I don't know how you play that and how you're playing Jack O.T.
That's just another roll.
Yeah. J.O.T. allows you to reroll. Reroll failed task.
Yeah. Okay.
Okay.
Well, if you guys want, I'll be happy to be lookout. But if you want to carry on to the other place, that's cool too.
I can pretty much drive up better than probably what the tracked vehicle can.
And your grab
vehicle.
How long would it take us to go on the grab bike? Two of us.
The grab bike's only. It's only going to carry the driver and probably a passenger, but the grab bike is super fast. If you brought that along, that's
hell yeah,
that's monster fast. I mean, I assume maybe he's doing some scouting or whatever. So Yeah, you got
that'd be fun.
Yeah, you got TL12 grab bike. I mean that thing goes.
Like
its cruising speed is 225 kilometers an hour.
Awesome. Okay, so what does the group think about me and Omen going out just to have a look at it and get back? That way, if anything happens, it's only the two of us that are gone, not the whole team.
Sure.
I don't mind, yeah. We can just stop here and have lunch.
I'd actually say carry on at a slower speed, but carry moving on forward. Don't be a
yeah. Considering that we could catch up,
yeah. Just perhaps go at half speed.
You're all right.
Okay. So I'll jump on the back of Omen's grab bike.
Okay.
Got my gear on.
So at that speed, it's only going to take you guys like 10 minutes to get out there. I mean, you get up above the.
We're taking a look around. We're not going straight up to the thing.
Right. Well, you can get up in the air, right? So, I mean, you're basically like flying around in the sky.
Yeah.
Hi, Scott.
Yo, Darwin, do you have a communicator?
Yep.
We've both got one.
Okay, yeah, I got a video communicator, so I don't know if they link up or they've got thingies, but we got that way of communication cool. You need.
Okay. So as we get closer, when we're about a click out from the signal, I want to try to do a visual.
Okay. Now that bike actually has active sensors on it too. So they have a 5 kilometer range. Now the only thing about the active sensors, of course, is I guess my best analogy is like submarine combat. Like when you actively scan, you are actively pinging. So anything else out there sees you light up. Yeah. Right, so that's how active sensors work. So you fly out there, sort of do a lap around and see what's going on out there. Mm-hmm. What you see, sure enough, is one of those, it looks like it's a robot, one of the construction robots, like a big robot, maybe had a malfunction.
Type, the floating type.
Yeah, they had the construction bot type, the floating type with all the arms.
Yeah.
Looks, who knows like how the hell it got out there or what it's doing out there, but it's basically like stuck in its grav must have gone out or something, but it's on the ground, sort of stuck in the mud, and around it, picking it apart, are sure enough those giant whippet spider things.
Mm-hmm.
And like, so whatever that signal is making is pissed them off. or maybe they can hear it too, or something about that robot. And the robot's not fighting back. The robot's not programmed to do that.
These are the car-sized spiders you're talking about.
Yeah, yeah. So around it is probably maybe like half a dozen or so of these big things, and they're just trying to tear it apart and pull wires out, and they're just kind of going at it. Now, it looks like they've probably been doing it for a long time.
Yeah.
I mean, like, it is a big metal 5,000 kilogram, machine. But it's not going anywhere.
Right.
And it's just sending out this pulse, and... It's got maybe a half a dozen, maybe some more of the trees underneath the canopies that you can't see.
Yeah. So what I'd like to know is there anywhere safe that we can get near the robot and gather a piece of equipment that would say that this is a kill that we've actually completed?
You're going to have to go through, I mean, they're all around it. Those big critters are, they're all over it. Like I said, whatever it is, it's like
from one of these things, what would we have to be taking back to have evidence that we've taken it out? Like the central core unit or the brain or the what?
So
because I wouldn't expect us to have to take back 5,000
right,
ton pieces.
Exactly. So you don't have to bring the carcasses back. They're probably sending out a signal that they're still active. Mm. And if you basically shut them down or kill them, basically, they're not going to send a signal back. And when no signals are coming back from that location, they'll know they're all shut down, right? And that they're all safe. That's probably the way they're going to want you to report that. I mean, they're not going to like want you to bring back a scalp or anything of these robots. Mm-hmm. Now, whether this was part of that site or not. There's no rhyme or reason. There's no one there to explain what this thing is doing out there, and what it's doing 30 kilometers off the beaten path. But it wandered out there for some reason, and The spiders are just going at it, they're trying really hard to rip into it, and it's got scratches all over. The paint's all scratched up in all the corners, and you know they've already plucked out all of its glass eyes and all that, and they're just whatever that that radio beeping sound. They must be able to hear it or something, or some sort of transmission that it's making, and it's just driving them crazy.
It's good to know, so I'll give that. Take a video of that so Stein can actually replicate that if we ever need it for future use against those creatures.
Absolutely. Good
is
idea.
Is there anything that I can identify on the robot that can actually shut down that signal? Or shut the robot down with a shot from my HEAP?
It had an antenna, but that's been broke off for long ago. It's probably something down inside of it.
Can it be hacked?
Was that?
Could it be hacked?
Probably not remotely. Mm. But if you've got them next,
Well, we're not getting them next to it.
You're probably not getting them next to it.
Not on the planet.
Yeah.
Have we seen spidery things jump at all?
Yeah, these things are like Volkswagen Beetles with like 20-foot long legs.
How far have we seen them jump?
Stay away.
They haven't paid you any mind whatsoever. You guys are.
How far have we seen them jump?
Oh, well, you haven't seen them jump. You haven't seen them do. I mean,
you don't know that yet, Steve.
You've seen them move pretty quick, though. I mean, since they're really, really long and have really, really long legs, they can make pretty long strides too. So, I mean, they can definitely walk faster than you can run.
That's okay, because I don't intend getting off the grave bike.
What about ride?
right on top of Volkswagen Beetle.
Let's keep the grave bike at least half a K away from them.
If we want to get close to this thing, we can set the sensors on the grave bike the same to produce the same
We don't want them chasing us, no.
Yeah, but then someone will walk in and then get to the robot and do whatever they need to. But yeah,
I know
that's just an idea if we want to do this.
Yeah, I understand that, maybe. It's just that there's only two of us out here right now. I mean, we are communicating to the team, but I don't want, I don't think we should endanger everyone else.
Let's just make a note for that signal just in case. But
we'll take down the GPS location if we've got a GPS locator.
Mm-hmm.
Of this, is there from the signal? Is there any identifier from the signal? This is robot XYZ241893.
Nope. If there is, you don't know what it is. It's just a repeating radio beacon.
Right.
Maybe it was a distress signal, or maybe it was something like that. Calling for another robot to come fix it, It's not
a
very
series of beeps.
Yeah, it just doesn't have a very far range. I mean, you were just picking it up as you were driving down, and you guys back in the Explorer as you're driving away, it's already starting to fade out.
Yep.
So it wasn't really a long range, maybe 10 clicks, range beacon that you were just barely catching the edge of when you were driving by.
Cool.
Is it any stronger now that we're
closer? As you guys are driving away, it got real strong when you got on top of it for you guys. It got real strong. Meanwhile, in the Explorer, as you guys are driving away, it's beginning to get weaker again.
Yeah. What I want to do, but my computer seems to be frozen, is I just want to find out the range of my snub pistol. So if you can tell me, John, because my...
I think it only goes medium range, and I think I'm pretty sure if it's medium range, it's 50 meters.
50 meters. That's a bit of a risk. Because I was just thinking, Omen, if we go down, so we're just above them, and I shoot the creature, the robot, just to see if that has any what that does to them and what that does to the robot. What do you think? But that means we've got to get within 50 meters of them.
And how big are these things? About the size of
Volkswagen.
Maybe there's, maybe there's a way to duplicate. We could write a program or duplicate that noise at a higher level and.
Yeah, no, start... I don't want to do that because I don't want them chasing us because there's only two of us. Any other ideas from anyone back in the truck what to do? Because you're getting the video feed through Kanga's communicator.
Kanga 2D feed.
Yeah.
I'd say plant it and set it as a timer. I don't want to lose my pocket computer.
I can't plant my ATPA rounds.
We can't. Get that close to it.
Yeah.
Without risking getting attacked by these things.
Yeah.
I just don't think we're equipped to handle it. So.
No. It's just a pity we didn't have some sort of little detonator and a bomb to go boom when it hits them.
Yeah.
Fly by and bomb them.
Yeah.
Well, it was funny because one of the things I was going to buy was a charge. But it was going to be one of those little breaching charges for doors.
Well,
but I didn't think I'd be able to get them in the city.
Well, here's what Crazy Igor has. So. Yeah.
It's just that this is part of our, I think this would be considered as part of our job, so we could get this one done and dusted. If we can just
Well, we can always come back.
We could, but yeah. It might have been moved on, it could have been taken out by something else.
Yeah.
I just thought if we could have evidence that we took it out, we've done the job.
You got a recording, right? Well, we don't have... Why don't we have any guns, man? I want my laser rifle.
I've got a Magnum and I've got a snub pistol. Unfortunately, snub pistol...
That's not going to do none with them spiders, though. Volkswagen-sized spiders...
HEAP will do something.
Snub pistol will. It'll hurt them, but you got to get mighty close.
Yeah, that's what I don't want to do. I'm imagining a cricket jumps far and a V-dub-sized cricket would jump further.
Yeah, 50 right
meters
top,
suddenly becomes 50 meters suddenly becomes really, really tight.
Crunchy.
Okay, here's an idea. Let's go away for a wee bit from this, get some trees, get a nice big heavy chunk of wood, go above them, drop it from a distance, and see what happens when it hits one of them. That'll be a hell of a lot of terminal velocity.
Go up about 100 yards, though. You don't give, or if not better. You'll have a better impact, and they won't feel as a chance of them jumping won't
That's
be.
What,
as,
oh no, I'm well. Saying go up a lot higher than that.
Yeah, how high can this thing go?
It's a grav bike. It can go to orbit, man. If you got a vaccine.
Yeah.
No, we only need like 500 meters or something up. And then drop something really heavy on them and see what happens.
Oh, I'm for it. I like that plan.
It's simple. Like we're pretty much out of danger if anything does happen, unless they suddenly can jump 500 meters, and then we're screwed.
I guess the only problem is if the Begrav bike can actually lift a big log like that, but yeah.
Well, I'm figuring on not too big, but you know, something significant. Something about 4 foot long and around about a foot in diameter. That should be enough of a chunk of weight to hit one of those things and see what happens.
Well, like I said, I mean it's about the size of a you know standard motorcycle. So you know, you guys are you know, sitting on it like you're sitting like you've been on a like on a cruiser or something. You know, I mean cargo it has like 0.05 kiloliters of cargo space. I mean basically you guys are gonna be like carrying this thing underneath each one of your arms.
Yep.
While he's flying it. Yep. While he's flying with the one
and
hand,
just
so.
Roll it off. So that's what we'll do. We'll do that.
But I need my arms. Bike.
Just I'll rest it on your shoulder and I'll carry it and push it off.
Okay. I mean, sure. Okay. So I mean, that's gonna take you a little while. So I mean, you guys. Meanwhile, the you know the explorers heading down the road. You know, la, move ahead, cut down the tree or cut down a you know.
We're just getting to a branch and breaking it off.
A branch or something, right? I mean, and you go and drop it on them.
See what happens.
It's not hard to hit them because they're pretty big. Yep. And like I said, there's a whole lot of them around that. Yep. Let me make a roll.
Okay. I guess it'd just be Dex because I don't think I'd have them.
Melee. Well, no. You're gonna hit one. I'm making a roll for me.
Okay.
Let's see. Okay, so. All right, you get their attention They see you.
Take this bike up. Take this bike up.
They are super creepy looking. Like, they're black and they look like almost like a crab and a spider.
Yep.
Really, really long. I mean, like a snow crab and a
whippersnapper. What are they, like carnivores or?
Yeah, put together. Well, suddenly all these like sparkly little black eyes like look up at you, and it's almost like one like nudges the other. It's almost like one nudges the other and is kind of like, hey, look at that. And then the next one is like, hey, look at that. Hey, look at that. Hey, look at that. Hey, look at that. And suddenly there's like
eight of them.
Yeah, suddenly there's like eight of them that like are looking up at you now.
And they're like, click, 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 click.
They are. They're like, got their arms up in the air. So they proceed to do this. One climbs on top of the other.
Up higher. And moving away, backing away somewhere.
Yeah,
and
moving away.
They're all climbing on top of each other.
Long story short, that's what began to happen. They seem to have some decent intelligence. They seem to have some kind of ability to communicate with each other. And they're driven by hunger and anger. so they are hungry and pissy and big. And that's probably all you need to know about these things. as you are sort of flying up and flying away, you see the mound sort of collapse and then like reconstitute kind of again. Mm-hmm. And then you see him eventually lose interest as you kind of like get far away from him, and then you see them all go back down beneath the trees again. So, you know,
when we did move away, we moved not towards the ATV, but in the opposite direction. Just
okay.
In case.
We're heading back to the farmland.
I don't care if we leave it to them. That's not our problem.
Okay. Well, lesson learned. Whatever these things are, they're big, they're pissy, and they're hungry all the time, or whatever.
And smart.
And pretty smart.
They have an intelligence. They have a cooperative intelligence.
Yep, and pretty smart. Okay. So you guys head back to the Explorer?
I just got to be away from the computer for a second, guys. Hang on. You carry on.
Yeah, after a couple of minutes circling around, head back.
Yeah. How are you? I'm good. Okay, so about another, you guys were about an hour full out from Zombie Chelney. So I imagine about the time that you're pulling in, the grab bike is pulling in. So as I stated, Zombie Chelney is kind of like a little citadel, it's kind of like out there in the middle of nowhere. It obviously has walls around it, and it's like a little fort that as you pull up close to it, you see what looks like some lookouts sort of peek out and look at you guys, and across your radio on the vehicle. He says, welcome to Zombie Chetney. What do you guys want?
A gun. The biggest
happiness we is love, a warm gun.
We love to shop.
We want some weapons.
Oh, you're there. Oh, you guys are here to do some shopping, eh? Come on.
Yeah.
So you see what looks like, it looks like it has like sensors and things that are on it, and probably they sweeped over a densitometer across you guys once or twice and got the what's inside of the vehicle. And after a few minutes, you see basically the big bay door at the bottom of it, start opening up, and then hear the guy on the radio say, hey, you guys, come on in!
I see, why not?
Yeah, this guy seems like a happy guy. Let's go.
Okay, so you drive in, and it's like a big vehicle bay in you know, in the bottom level of the Citadel, and you see a couple other vehicles parked there. You know, he's got a grab vehicle, you know, probably like an air raft of some kind, and like a vehicle kind of like yours, but it looks like it's been sort of like, I don't know,
it's being blinged out.
It's been kind of like road warriored, like armored up, parked there too. And you see three or four techs, you know, like guys walking around, and a bunch of robots, you know, a bunch of like about man-sized robots. You see like a big cargo robot. I mean, it seems pretty, you know, pretty active, but there's only four or five guys there. One guy pulls up, you know, like walks up to you. He's got like the construction hat on, the little, you know, like the yellow coveralls, you know, and he kind of gives you the rundown on, you know, basically you're going to, you know, if you want to go upstairs to see, you want to get out of here and go upstairs, you know, you got to leave all your weapons behind, and they're going to like, it's almost like going through an airport security checkpoint, pretty much. You know, they're going to like check the contents of all your stuff, and then they're going to give you the full body scan and the whole thing. And then you'd be allowed to go upstairs. And, you know, the guy says, you know, then you can go upstairs where all the action takes place.
Cool.
I just want to make sure that we left that big round computer thing back home, right?
It's up to you. I mean, I think you're the last one that had it, so.
Yeah, I left that thing back there.
Okay.
I'm going to grab a cigarette and one of the bottles of vodka that I brought and go through and hit upstairs, go through the scanner and stuff.
Okay. It is pretty much as reported. I mean, one of the other tech guys, like, you know, brings the vehicle in and puts you over to a parking spot, you guys get out, they all seem to be pretty happy people, and the robots all have like Stewart programs in them, so they're all real friendly too. And They're happy robots. They're all happy robots. They probably have like little LED lights for faces. You know, that all have like little smiley faces on them. So you go through, you know, pretty much, just like airport security, pretty much. You know, they give you the full body scan. If you have any weapons of any kind on you, they're going to get scanned. They're going to get sniffed out. So just FYI. And they'll make you. They don't like any liquid, etc. When you're walking through the full body scan, it's a pretty high tech, you know, setup. I mean, he kind of scans you down on the molecular level, and pretty much anything you would even be carrying, like in your blood, probably one of you guys, you know, the machine tells you, like, you guys are right on the cusp of having a cold, drink more citrus or something, you know. I mean, it's pretty much like that kind of, that kind of level of body scanning. So as you get ushered through there, go upstairs. You have like some, it looks almost kind of like the inside of a ship, you know, I mean, like the inside of it is sort of like set up like that. I mean, there's crew quarters and there's lounge areas and there's stuff like that. And it's kind of like a, I almost want to say it's like a hotel slash fort slash mall, you know, that's all walled up and stuff. And, you don't see any, what look like to be any other customers. But you probably count at this point maybe going on a dozen people. They're all wearing like jumpsuits of various colors and fashions. They all seem to be walking around with like, it looks like maybe like a sonic stunner or something. I mean, they do seem to be armed, your equipment packs or whatever gear and things, all kind of going about their business. And a steward, someone who's obviously dressed up, come to see you guys, and he says, let me make a roll here. Okay. Okay. So he says, he's looking at his little wrist computer, and he's like, Hey, you guys are the new guys. and then he points at you, Darwin. Darwin, and he says, "Hey, you gone VR, man?"
Just before we get there, sorry, I was away. I just want to. I'll be wearing my Magnum gun, but I will be my snub pistol I've hidden.
Okay, so you go through. You go through what is probably like a Tech 13 checkpoint, and every single thing like that gets snooped out, and they won't let you bring it up. Even the plastic knife, like they snoop that too. I mean, like I said, I was telling these guys, they scan you to the point where, like, if you're on the verge of a cold, like they tell you, like it's that kind of full body scan.
Okay, so
it's like the scanners on Total Recall.
Okay, so just before we go there, Dr. Stein, where did you leave the tablet?
Oh, I think we just discussed that. I think they said they left it behind.
Yeah, we didn't bring that good. With us.
Good. Just want to make sure that's all.
Okay.
Well, cool. Well, so like, I've got it. I'll just leave it in the
ATM. So you go upstairs, see the see the steward, and you know you guys got two renown now, and you probably have higher than that. So he knows who you are. You know, he's gotten off the local, the local net, tales of your prowess. So he says, hey, the new guys, you guys come on. I know why you guys are here. Come on in. I'll introduce you to Crazy Igor.
Great.
Cool.
Okay. So you go up another level, and it seems like yet another layer of security. And this level is pretty pimped out. It's like velvety. There's like Adidas symbols everywhere.
I can't wait to see gold chains the size of them.
It is pretty cheeky breeky. Yeah, I mean it's pretty pimped out in Russian trampy style. there's gold things, all that kind of stuff. So you see Crazy Igor is he's a mountain of a man. Like, so he's got crazy eyes, so you know where the nickname comes from. He's maybe 6'4", 6'5". He's super built and he's super tattooed. You'll notice between this guy and the other guy you got that you recall from the tattoos, you probably have a little bit of knowledge of that at this point, and you can immediately see that everything he's got on him is probably legit. You know, all the symbolism that he's got in tattoos across his body is probably legit. He's got like the velvet red running suit.
I got the perfect clip for all that if I can ever find it.
Like the super white, like retro Adidas looking things on, you know?
Yeah.
It all looks like brand new. And he's got giant gold chains around his like his hand computer is all encrusted with gold and stuff, and it's like going up his arm to his elbow. And then he's got chains on the other hand. And
yeah, he's a player.
Big chains all around his neck. And he's like, hey, it's the new guys.
And I'll say, hey, it's Igor.
He says, come on in. And you know, everything's all plushy. There's already a steward bot bringing out food and booze. And it's like, you know, recessed couches and... He says, wait. You see him click some things on, and some like 70s funky music starts playing in the background, and all the lights dim, and there's like the red lights and the green lights. It's all that, man. It's like 70s rag carpet, shag carpet, and plushy pillows, and the whole thing.
Nice.
Right.
So the biggest thing that immediately strikes you, obviously, is that this is all culture, and it, as tacky as it is probably a stupid amount of creds.
Mm-hmm. It is probably
a stupid amount of money that he's, showing off here.
So kind of like this dude.
But it's the Adidas running suit though. It's like the
wow,
right?
Yeah, I mean, it's like the leash. Yeah, he's got it's the running suit. It's the whole the red polyester or it's probably like crushed velvet, velour. It's velour. It's red velour. It's red velour.
It's special. I say
with the with the Adidas symbols all over it, and he doesn't even know what the Adidas even means anymore. Like nobody knows. Like nobody even knows what that even means. It's just a symbol that came from old Earth, and it was cool. So everybody wants it all over their crap.
Right. It was a cult.
Yeah, it was a cult or something. Like they don't even know. Like, they don't even know what it was all about, but they just know that it's really cool. So you guys come and sit down, he says, "So, what brings you guys all the way out here to Zombie Champion Stava?"
Robots.
Gotta do a little robot cleaning, my friend.
He says, "Robots? You guys want to buy some robots?"
No. We're here to decommission some robots further down the line.
Ah, you guys do some KPB work, huh? Mm-hmm. So where are you guys going?
Just further down the line to some little place.
He says, yes.
Site 215, I believe.
Ah, he says, okay. So they having some trouble with the robots down in 215, eh?
Mm-hmm. They are. They sent the best.
And so he starts popping up on his hand computer. He's like, "So what you guys what are you guys going after these guys with? Let me see here." And obviously he's got like a robot down there crawling all over your vehicle. Mm-hmm. It's like looking around inside of it and stuff. You kind of see over his shoulder. He's got a little video, like first person view of some little mouse bot or something that's running all over your vehicle. And he's like, "Hey, you guys got almost no kit, man."
That's right.
That's why we're here, man.
Yeah.
"Man, you guys are gonna trade." He says, "Oh," he starts laughing. He's like, "Oh man, you got those little EMP pistols. Those are for shooting like the garbage robots back in the city, man. They ain't gonna take down no big giant 5,000 kilo car, your own bot."
Well, I tell him that's right. But that's the same sort of attitude we had from what was the name of the group that we took down?
The Nose Bostoy?
The No Voice Story. They sort of have that sort of attitude about our ability too. So, that's all cool.
Says, "Oh yeah, I saw that fight. I saw that fight. Yeah. That made news all around cities."
Yep. So, we might not need that much kit, but we might get some kit.
He says, "Yeah, man, you guys are gonna get killed, especially if those robots out there are crazy. Kinda like me." He says, "Those robots, man, they got the laser drills, and they got the man. They just chew you up."
Yep.
We want to find out more about that stuff.
Yep.
So then he kind of gets back and he starts kind of twiddle his fingers. He's like, "So, what kind of stuff are we talking about here? What interests the new guys?"
Well, I'll just let the rest of the team talk. Go for it, guys.
Definitely could use some nice guns, some weapons of some.
Cool. He says, "Oh, guns! Nice. I got the guns, man. I got the A-number-one best stuff up in here. I'm telling you."
Well, can we take a look at what you got? What guns you got? I'm just trying to find out where this all that
up. Is there like some gun racks? The walls swivel around and shows us some
gold hangers.
That's too tacky.
Guns hanging on little hooks on breadboards.
he says,
he just presses the
That's low rent, man. That's low rent. I got the high tech 3D going on here, man.
Oh, so you see, it takes us to the upper room with the spark, with the spot, with the track spotlights and the, the soft music.
Right. So he gets on his hand computer again.
I wondered if we got anything like electromagnetic type of grenade, EMC, like grenades or something that could shut down the robots temporarily long enough for us to defuse them.
Right. So he starts popping up some things here. He's like, "Well, I don't know what you guys' price ranges are. And he says, how about we start with this? And he pulls up, like, you know, so basically the table has got, there's computers probably in the walls everywhere. It's just, you can't see them. Suddenly there's like the whole like blue Star Wars 3D floating pictures of things. He starts popping up, you know, and the first thing he pops up, he says, so I only got a couple of these, but I'm going to show them to you. I got a couple of surplus Novorossiysk military rifles. Never been shot, only dropped once.
Oh, it must be French.
Unless they don't break the ice.
So what you see in front of you is a picture of, it's an advanced heavy accelerator rifle 12.
How much for one of them bad boys?
He says, I only got two. The starting price is 24K.
Can I use laser weapons for?
Okay, I don't have bribing, but I have persuasion.
And I even got a couple magazines. You pay full price, I throw in the magazines.
How many magazines?
He says, let me check here. I got, I think I got a half a dozen. Like I said, you can't, this is top tier military equipment. This stuff is, it's hard to come by. Totally illegal. Totally illegal, man.
I'm gonna try to use it. If I can use persuasion, I'm gonna try to see if I'm gonna say I'm interested, but what about pistols? Do you have any pistols too? Auto pistols? I'm sure you do.
So he says, besides having all the wimpy, like, dart gun stuff, that's all civilian stuff. So he says, okay, let's see what else we got to put in small arms here. And the next thing he pulls up, he says, okay, so I got a couple of these too. So these are civilian laser rangefinders. They're a little heavy, but they've been modified to be super powerful. So basically, you've got like a giant laser gun here. So, and that's exactly what he's got.
I can full picture this guy.
And they're in the catalog. So, they are alternative light laser designators. They're Tech-Level 14.
How much?
They probably are not as heavy hitting as the accelerator rifles, but they have a crazy far range because they're lasers. Now, they're pretty heavy too. So, like, it's probably like you'd be shooting a small bazooka, but it'd be a laser gun. It's just because basically what it is, it's a civilian rangefinder, probably off of a really big piece of construction equipment that they've pirated and like turned into a weapon.
That might be nice with the spiders.
He says, also, man, super illegal to even be doing this work.
No.
He says those. I got a few more of those, so I can let those go for 20K.
Can we test them? Can we get to fire it ourselves?
Now he says I'd be more than happy to show you, but you know, like, I'm biz man. I gotta see if you've got the creds up front.
I got
33,000 credits. I've got some credits. I show him the 20K worth of credits, roughly, okay, or proof of it. I don't show him anymore.
Be on a card or a cred stick or something that he can scan.
And
he says. I don't know if I've got. Man, I had sold many pistols, but I just sold almost everything.
I'd like a basic auto pistol.
He says, I got. I tell you what. He says, I got some acid projectors. These are Tech-Level 12 too. These are like air powered, better than civilian version. They shoot acid, man. Like, they melt your face off, like 50 meters.
Does it melt metal? Oh,
man, groovy.
They probably have a pretty powerful acid, and they're air powered, so like basically they wouldn't attack armor, so it would be a corrosive test. So like pretty much if you squirted this on somebody who had standard armor, it would still get them. It'd be almost like they didn't have armor. So if he squirted you and you had cloth armor on, it wouldn't help you at all. Because they would just get in between all the.
Well, watch for those bad boys.
I mean, it's like a 50 meter long super soaker that shoots caustic acid. He says, those are pretty cheap, man, because they're pretty small. I just, those are 2K. Those are 2,000 a piece, man. Those I got a bunch of those.
I could take one of those.
I'm going to try to haggle him down to, I'm not going to haggle him much, but I want an accelerator rifle and then the acid one with the rounds for 25. I'll give you 25K for that. I try to use my persuasion skill. Okay. I want the acid pistol. And I want the accelerated rifle.
Gotcha. Okay, so you see him going through, like, he's kind of clicking the next button on his computer, and the pictures are popping up, and those are kind of like all the small weapons that he's got. And then you see him go through, like, what looks to be, like, one or two, maybe, like, robots, but they're, like, really big robots looking like a gun sticking out of them. And he's like, no, that's you guys aren't interested in that. And then, like, what seems to be, like, a tank goes by. He's like, no, that's way too much. He's like, that's too aggressive. He like loops back around to the accelerator rifles again, and he's like, yeah, man, advanced heavy accelerator rifles, man, they shoot a hole through anything. Kill these robots, and you kill these robots outright.
I want one. I offer him 25 for both the acid gun and the accelerator rifle, together with the rounds, right now. So that's 1,000 less. That's getting. I'm trying to push to get the. Because it'd be 26. I'm trying to get just 1,000 less.
So I'm gonna say, it's probably only routine because he's so nice, but it's definitely going to be a opposed role. So, in his skill. Is 3 and his social standing is going to gives him a +1. So if you can pull off,
I have persuasion. I think 2.
Okay. So give me. You're looking for a seven plus your take one skill and one attribute.
I want to go with my intelligence. I get a +2 for my intelligence, and I have persuasion 1.
Okay, so tell me this. So how are you going to use intelligence in the conversation to be able to use it as a modifier?
Well, I'm going to try to use persuasion to say you're one heck of a businessman, and we greatly appreciate it. We think you're going to be a great help for us. I'm blowing a little salesman smoke up his rear,
okay.
Which I mean he's familiar with. But this is what I'd like to pay, and I mean I'd really like this, and I'm kind of tight on funds and da 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 da. But I'll give you and I could use both these weapons. I like them. I'm offering you this, and I hope this is my offer right now for these two. And I put it out there in a very friendly, respectable, very well thought out, intellectual, business friendly savvy.
So it's 24 for the rifle and 2 for the acid.
Yeah, I'm only going 1,000 under for both together. Yeah, I said I got 25 for both.
Okay, so
I'm trying to angle a little bit.
Okay, so he is a four. His stuff is altogether a 4, so you can give me a 7 or better with your pluses.
I got a +3, boom. I don't know what I got here. I'm on the
okay. So
10.
Okay, so +3, and it's an opposed. It's a confrontation roll, so it's opposed. So it's going to be -4, 4 because of his skills. So that's only going to give you a 6.
Okay.
This may not be the time for you to want to use this because it's not really that big a deal, but you have, in Mega Traveler, you get brownie points. You get 1 per term of service. So right now in your character sheet, you have 3 brownie points. Brownie points allow you to re-roll something, or you can add a +1. But once you use it up, it's gone.
I'll save them.
They're probably for bigger things than this. And you do get them as role player awards, but you don't get them. You get like 1 in adventure kind of thing. So in this case, it would help you, but for 1,000 less credits, it probably wouldn't be worth using the brownie boy for it.
Yeah.
Don't you have Jack of Trades?
I do have Jack of All Trades.
So trying to convince him again is gonna bump up your task level from routine to difficult. So then it's gonna be an 11 plus with your +3 and -4.
Give him the 1,000.
Pay him then if he's not biting for that.
No, he's not really biting. He's a businessman.
I offer him the 26, but I also tell him I would really desire a simple basic auto pistol, or you know, like I want a pistol 45 caliber, whatever. That's pretty common. We're talking 500 credits, maybe.
Yeah. Besides the ass projector, besides like that, there are like he's got for the straight up normal price, he's got advanced heavy pistols out the wazoo. Like he's got, I mean, those are like pretty commonplace on the, you know, amongst criminals and things.
Advanced heavy pistol. What does that mean?
Advanced heavy pistol. So in the range weapons, so here's the range weapons. The advanced heavy pistol is there. They're 600. They're nothing. I mean, and I think you guys got a couple of them, don't you?
I want one of those too. So I'll give him 2660. I want an advanced heavy pistol, and I'll take both the other ones. And I'll subtract that from my total, and I'll put that in my
gear. He's got a bunch of the ass projectors. They have...
How much damage do those do, acid projectors, in
the... the acid projectors, the snub acid projector 12, they're corrode 4, so basically they're a plus 4, so pretty much they cancel out cloth armor. I mean, they're...
they cancel out any of the armor we have, more or less.
Pretty much, yeah. I mean, they're...
Actually, combat or better would be your only protection.
Yeah, they're so... They're fairly damaging. They don't shoot real far, but yeah, they're fairly damaging.
And the accelerated rifle's got to be totally pretty thrust.
The accelerated rifle's awesome, and that's on there too. It's the it's the advanced heavy accelerated rifle 12. And he said I got one more of these.
Well, I'm gonna spend the money. I had 33,000 some odd credits left. I'm going to add them to my character sheet. I buy the three guns. I get the heavy pistol, the acid pistol, and the accelerator rifle.
Okay, the accelerator rifle's a beast. The accelerator rifle's bullet 10. So that thing is... And it's got...
I've got Rifleman 1, so yeah, I want a rifle, man.
I'll tell you how the settings work. It has...
Can we mount it like on a ring mount?
A vehicle? So it's basically just a rifle, like it's basically like a assault rifle kind of rifle, but you totally could.
Right.
If you look at the stats on it, it's super. Yeah, it's a monster. I mean, it's a monster killer gun. It's bullet 10. So if you turn it up, if you turn it to setting 3, it would be bullet 30. Right. I mean, it's like shooting through.
Whoa.
I mean, it'll shoot through like some armored vehicles. You know, it's and it's got burst. I mean, it's a monster gun. It's super, super,
I like it.
Oh, so it's not viewable to all players? Let me see here.
Yeah, I noticed that you're flashing a lot of handouts and things, weapons and maps, but if I X them, I can't recall them later.
Okay, so yeah, so they they're in there, but they're probably a layer.
How much does the accelerator rifle weigh?
It is 2.5 kilograms.
Okay, it's not that bad.
Nah, it's a rifle. I mean, it's basically what it is. It's a rocket gun that can shoot rockets really, really fast. Like it's a, like sort of like a magnetic rocket gun. Yeah.
Okay, so you call that what, an acid heavy pistol?
Yeah, it's in there too. The I have that in there as well. It is the
snub acid projector 12.
Yeah, modified snub acid projector 12. That's in there too. You know, something that's really easy to do is you can select that whole block of text and copy paste into your character sheet. It's super easy to do. You just grab that whole thing.
Yeah, I did it. Have a look at the way I set up my sheet.
Yeah, you can grab that whole thing, drag over it, you know, Alt-C, and then go to your character sheet, press Alt-V, and then do that. So he says, so he's got two of these. Like I said, he's only got half a dozen magazines. Because, again, they're super-duper military surplus items that there's not a bunch of them around. And, of course, anything you've seen... I mean, this gun's a dread killer to any sort of situation that you've been in thus far that required combat.
Wow.
So that's what's up with that. So like I said, he's got the laser detonators. Those are 20,000 apiece. He's got one more accelerator rifle. That's 24,000. He's got a couple, several of those snub acid projectors. He didn't have a whole lot of acid laying around though, so like he's got, so I think they have like maybe 20 shots apiece, maybe they start out with 20 squirts. He's probably got another couple canisters laying around, but he doesn't have like, you know, a crate of them or anything. He's got more guns than he's got ammo. And then those cheap heavy pistols that you guys saw those other gang members have. He's got a bunch of those lying around. You guys already got a couple of those. Like I think you got like three or four of those already. But he's got some more round of those. That would be base price. And he's probably got like 100 rounds of ammunition.
What about this light plasma gun?
Yeah, he's oh man, plasma guns. So I've had those before, but they are hard to come by, and you do not have that kind of money.
$24,000.
I just picture this guy every time you fake his voice.
Oh man. No, I didn't say heavy, I said light.
Yeah, he says, so you guys got to take down my info, and if you ever need anything else, you let me know, because I got some decent things going on right now, but I'm not fully stocked like I normally am. No.
Really need just laser weapons, because that's all I can fire. That's all I can decently use.
So he's got the laser designators. He's got a couple of those.
Is that in here somewhere?
Yeah. So it's go down to the bottom where the tech level. It goes by tech level. All the weapons. Go down to the range weapons and go down to the alternate light laser designator 14.
Yeah.
So it's really good. It shoots really far. It doesn't have a lot of damage. It's burn 3, pen 2. So basically, it's gonna be +5 to the armor roll.
That's little, right. I plan to stay well away.
But if you look at it, it shoots like kilometers.
Yeah, I'll take one.
It shoots a distance. The nice thing about that, it's 9 kilos. It's like super heavy, but it's got 100 rounds in it.
You might end up having to melt it on my body, and then hide it.
Yeah, it's a monster.
Yeah, I'll take that one and a squirter. He doesn't have any other laser weapons.
Nah, he doesn't. He doesn't. He mentions some things going on with some local farmers that needed some guns.
What about any EMP stuff?
He'll have the same thing you guys got, and he says, man, you don't want to. He says you don't even want to use those. He says just throw those away, man.
Yeah, just yeah.
Which weapon is this on here? Advanced heavy accelerated rifle. Okay.
12. Yep.
Oh, he's making money on that. They're 6,000.
Yeah, he really is.
Yeah.
he doubled the price.
Yeah, he doubled, really is.
More than tripled it.
Quite. He really is.
He's making bank on that. We should have been able to talk his ass.
He's crazy, Igor, man.
All right. Well, so how much does he laser designated?
Got a market.
And I would say probably none of you have ever even seen one of these to touch up close.
Yeah.
I mean, probably the closest thing anybody's gotten to is Omen. Omen has, you know, they use the accelerated carbines a lot, and that's kind of like basically a shorter rifle, a shorter version of that the Scouts used. You're familiar with it. You're familiar with this. This is basically a bigger, more military version of the gun that you used to carry around.
There's the sight and all that stuff. How much was the light laser? That was 20,000. 20,000.
All right. And I picked advanced police suit, which I imagine is some kind of cloth type. It's 3,700.
Okay, so the suits are actually powered, and anything from there down, you're going to want to get through some sort of illicit means of some. They're not going to be available, unfortunately. All the standard armors that are above that will be.
Okay, so I got to pick a different armor and reimburse myself.
Yeah. So and as for armor, I wonder if he's got. Let me just roll my.
Yeah, I was about to say. Well, what armor does he have?
Let me roll my thing here. I didn't think about putting any armor.
So what is it? So the acid spitters are the modded snub acid projector type?
Okay, so yeah, the snub acid projector is it's near the top. Armor wise, he's got surplus stuff. So let me look see what surplus.
You can't buy police suits or anything. You gotta have a. Everything on here is a suit. Wait a minute, combat armor, battle dress. I'm looking now.
So basically, the way T5 does it is suits are like suits on down are all powered or all have like computers or sensors or things in them. They modify your strength, and some of them do, and that kind of, and they have armor against more than one kind of thing. So like what I'm using is I'm using the T5 armor rules. So like if you get shot with like a gun that shoots like basically lightning, cloth armor is not going to help you at all because it's electricity. It's just going to fry you anyway. So you need something that has actually like.
Oh, okay. Here's the cost at the end.
Yeah. So
it's like I'm going to have to go with standard cloth then. We can't get ab ladder reflux.
Yeah, you can't get that. So everything on that first chart, everything in the red chart there. That's all like straight up basic stuff that's available.
That's classic trail. Okay.
That's available around.
Can I get a flak jacket and cloth armor? Does that make a difference? Basic.
Yeah, but not as much as adding them together. We use Striker for that, and I think it would increase it by about half as much. So he does have. I don't know. They're much better than the. Let me roll how many he's got here. Okay, so he's got four of this, because they're low tech and they look like pretty used. The standard police suit six, which is doesn't it's got about as much armor as cloth, but it has since it's totally encompassed. It does have flash protection, cave protection, sonic protection. It's even got a little side protection, and it's insulated. So insulation 12, which means if you were wearing it. Pretty much the cold wouldn't bother you.
They got cold weather clothing, but how much does he want for those?
He's charging just five times marking up on that, so that's gonna be what about 8,000. So standard police suit six. If you're interested, he's got four of those, but they look like so, and they're from. Like surplus ones from
1,700 base price. he's going to charge us 5,000 for it.
He sure is.
He is. I think I'm going to tell him to smoke one on that. I don't know.
It is better than cloth armor, and it has you know radiation protection and sonic protection and all kinds. I mean, so basically, what it is, it's probably like a suit with a helmet. Almost like a biker, sort of biker looking suit that has a real close fitting.
Oh hell, I'll buy one.
A real close fitting helmet on it too.
I'll buy one.
It actually does have some basic sensors. It does have a grid com with a range of six. So which means now if you know, also look down there, it increases your dexterity by one, but it does lower your endurance by three. So like it's got some weight to it, but it's not powered. It doesn't increase your strength. And if you look at the speed one there, you can't run in it.
Like it lowers your endurance by three. My endurance is already six.
And the maximum speed is one. So it means you can trot in it, but you can't full on run in it.
I'm gonna pass on it. I'm gonna go with cloth armor.
But it does have basic sensors and things. So you know, I mean, it would actually have like little scanners and things that are part of it. And it can run for 24 hours. It's got a 1 day power supply. So you know, just throwing it out there, you guys. So you guys are interested. So he does have four of those.
Quick question. So we couldn't buy. So what? So we only could buy the armor and the red chart.
No, that's available for anybody. I mean, that's just what he's got for sale right now.
No, you but back in the that. Back in the first city, what? What armors could we have bought? Because I did buy like
all the ones at the top. like all the ones
at the top.
Yep, all the ones at the top. All the where it says basic protections, because those those aren't powered. Those aren't electronic in any way. They're just basically, you know, armor material that you're wearing on your body in some way, shape, or form. And they'll be pretty much all over. They'll be pretty much all over the place to get a hold of.
Okay.
Because, like I said, unfortunately, that's the thing about the, and you know, Igor knows it. I mean, that's the thing about the planets. The law levels are super duper high, you know, in all of the, all the you know all the plant basically all of them. I mean, you know, the Union planets, the New Columbian planets, you know, law levels in the city are super high. So you know, weapons and things are just tough to, you know, tough to get, and you know, you never want to pull it out. Like that accelerator rifle, you'd never want to pull that out in a city. Like you know, that would make that, you know, they'd be all over you. They'd be all over you for that. So,
okay. Yeah, I don't see that as being a good thing.
So those suits were 8K.
Times 5, 5, 6, 7. Yeah, 8. Yeah, 8 even. Yeah, 8. Yep, 8,000 even.
Okay. Yeah, I'll grab one.
And they are. Yep. So this is. So like I said, so they're not real heavy, but I guess the best way to say this is they're kind of stiff because they've got multiple layers of different kinds of protection in them.
What armor is this?
So he's got four suits of standard police suits, six, which are basically electronic looking.
Right.
They look like maybe biker leather with a real close fitting helmet. They have some basic sensors in them.
Fasten on that.
They have comms. They lower your endurance, but they increase your dexterity by one. But they don't increase strength any. So, like some of these are powered, you know, and have got lots of cool things they do. But the suits are like a smaller version. You know, they're like electronic clothes, pretty much. You know, and then you start getting up into the dress and all in armor and all that.
Yeah, I'm just trying to look for them.
I'm just doing the regular cloth armor for 250. I'm passing on that. We got that. I've got all my equipment now, and I've subtracted it from my credits on my character sheet.
Okay.
I also, I hope you don't mind, I erased the whole history of the character, and I just put equipment.
That's fine.
Yeah, we've got underneath. So it's all on the sheet. You can get to it.
Yep. All right, so while you guys are shopping and exchanging creds and all that, I mean, he kind of goes around and gives everybody else the questioning. You know, he's like asking where everybody's from, and he's like sort of detecting, you know, your accents and asking how you guys got together. And I mean, he's kind of, you know, you guys really haven't been in the you know, ribbed for information, so he's kind of like. You know, you see he's being real nice, but you definitely know everything that you're saying is probably being like recorded and stuff, and he's sort of getting some info, you know, and you know, whatever your you know, backstories or whatever is on all you guys
and stuff, eh?
So I tell him I'm a curious like walking on the sand and my favorite drink is white wine. And give him a wink.
and I'm sure at some point, you know, like one of the walls like turns into a TV, and
oh yeah,
you know, he plays back the Dostoevsky Station knife fight, yeah, for you guys.
Oh, just the knife fight, okay.
Yeah, and he says
not the other video.
okay, so you say he hears you say just a knife fight, he's like, hey man, it's not that late yet. We haven't had enough to drink yet. He gives you the wink. he gives you.
Right.
All right.
So he's like right there on the edge of his seat because entertainment, pop culture, all kind of stuff. He's like, oh man, I love this part. You guys are like gold. You guys are just standing in front of each other, just like chopping each other and cutting. It's like no. No blocking, no. You're just like two men, just manning up and cutting each other to death, man. It's like so bloody. he's like, watch this. He doesn't even block, man. He just takes the stick. Look, he's sticking it in his gut. He's like going through the he's like right on the edge of his plushy couch, and he's like, "Oh man, what's..." He's like, "Oh, and the blood's squirting." It's like, so, you know, and then. And
do they have like, sportscasters like that?
Pretty much, pretty much.
Got, like, I say something like, "Yes, I seem to remember something like that when I was there."
And he's got like every angle of it too. So like, you know, he like presses his buttons, and you see like the camera like flip over to another one. So he's like, "Oh man, let's watch that again." Awesome. He's like, it's like, you know, you see this it's like this time when you like jab him in the, or no, he's jabbing you in the abdomen. Remember, he like stabbed you right in the abdomen. He's like, "Oh man, look at this, look from this side, look from this side." He's like, it's like going around to each side. He's like replaying, like stick.
That's great. Yeah,
like,
there's
"Oh man, the head hurts so bad."
Yeah, there's like an actual control. Hello.
Yep.
You hear me?
Yep.
Yeah, I was gonna say there's an angle button on my DVD remote, but there's no DVD I've ever had that uses that feature at all. You can switch the angle.
Yeah.
So it exists right now, but I guess they use it to death in the future.
Yeah.
Is that the fight that I walked in at the last second with the sandwich, or was that the one I missed?
It was in that Russian nightclub that apparently they allow duels for sport. Were you there?
I don't believe so. I think that's the one I missed.
Mm. Yeah. No. Classic stuff. And that's not the only video that was that night.
That was debuted that evening.
Yeah.
Mm.
So he's got like tons of, like I said, there's tons of food and like stuff he tells you got flown in from the coast and like seafood and all this kind of stuff, and especially now that he's made a mint on you guys, like he's super happy now that it, like, once the credits have cleared, you know, he's like, "Hey man, you guys are so easy to deal with. I like you guys. I like
it." Yeah, he says,
"Man, I tell you what though, you guys got the lame ass name. You got to come up with the Freelancer Crew name, man. The Freelancer Crew got like all the cool ass names, man. You guys are good. It's gonna stick. I'm telling you, man. New guys is gonna stick. If you don't think of something, think of something soon."
I'll just turn around and ask them. "So, what sort of name would you suggest?"
Oh, you know he's got several. Here you go.
"I
don't know, man. I don't know, but I don't know if you might want not to call yourself the Freaks."
Oh no. No.
he's winking again. You know who he's winking at.
I smile.
So, and he's also super excited when the weapons come out, all unloaded, of course. He says, "Of course, you know, the ammunition will be down in your vehicle when you guys get ready to leave." He says, "I 100% guarantee everything working great. Everything is good. We'll be A number one, super good for you guys." He says, but "Let me show you how it works, man. Like, look at this." And he's like showing you the settings on the accelerator rifle. He's like, "Oh man, this has got the gyro stabilization and everything, man." And he basically gives you like the whole, like, "Here's how they all work" kind of thing. Mm-hmm.
Do you have any explosives?
Let's check. And blink. He does not. He says, "Man, you just missed, like, I had some little grenades. Of course, I think about right now I can hear the farmers all blowing themselves up with them. they wanted like the whole case, and none of them had any kind of training whatsoever, so I don't even know if they even made it back." He says, "But you guys got to remember me, and tell, I'd say tell your friends, but everybody already knows about me."
Mm-hmm.
He says, "In the future, you need any kind of stuff, you've got special requests, you just tell me. You just send me the secret message on the darknet, and I'll get right on it."
We've already got a mechanical tools, don't we?
Yep.
All right, cool.
As far as like standard equipment and stuff too, he's probably got a truckload of that stuff sitting around too. So, I'm sure, if you need something else like that, and he would probably actually be fairly piece and then sell it to you at normal price.
Oh no, because now I'm just thinking about okay, if something's in our way, can we cut through metal? Like a blowtorch or something like that.
Some portable welders, I'm sure.
Yeah, so that laser can probably do.
But I'm carrying it around like a bazooka.
Yeah, pretty much carrying around like a bazooka. So,
I'm just talking about cutting standard. That should be a blowtorch in the mechanical thing.
Right. So penetration of 6. Just FYI, it can do brick and stone. You can cut through, so it can almost cut through a starship interior world. You probably so instead of cutting through bigger things like that, you probably just end up shooting it up, shooting holes in it, stuff. But stuff like that, wood or whatever, anything. Lighter than that gun can actually kind of saw through. And basically it's a big long square looking thing that once again was probably stuck on the outside of some kind of big vehicle for laser range finding for stuff, and somebody hacked it and jacked it up and put pistol handles and stuff on it, and now
it's a mount on the bike,
and now it's a gun. So he says, okay, so, before we, get the party started, he says, I got anybody want that gun? That's the only one I got left. So I got the one more. You're going to need, man. I tell you, man, there's a whole bunch of robots there, big robots. You're going to wish you had more guns.
I'll buy them. Yeah. Yeah, we need to get all of his guns. Just get them. Whoever's got spare cash, just get them.
What about stuff?
You may never see them again, unless you get the big time cash.
How much were they again?
It is 24,000. Now, the only thing is, he's only got a total of six magazines. Now, each one of them has 40 rounds in it, so that would be 3 each. But again, when you see the damage of these things, I mean, they are bullet 10, and they can be turned
if no one else is buying it.
And they can be turned to a setting 3, so.
I'm a scientist, not a marine.
Oh, man, I twist your arm. Okay. Now, he says, now let's drink till we can't see straight.
And shoot guns.
What about things that, are EMP based or might be effective against, mechanical beings?
He's only got those, like, basically what you guys got, and he says just throw them away. He says don't even use those things on those robots, man. He says the big one's got a little bit of EMP protection. I don't know who sold you those things or who told you those were going to be good for what you guys are doing. He says if you're going after like a dog robot or like a little cleaning robot or something like little bitty and weeny like that, those guns are great. They're great in the city.
A Roomba, yeah. I gotta salt some Roombas.
Not these little big giant things.
Quick question: the suits. Do you need the power supply to move them, or are they just the sensors, or is it for like the whole suit?
It powers the whole suit. So it works for a day. It'll work for a day, okay. and probably what it's doing is the suit. It has armor. Like in it that needs power, like kind of like in Traveler, some of the higher tech level metals, like Bond is super dense, is actually has power running through it at all times, to increase electron charge. So basically, what the suit probably is probably like a leather suit or like leather looking suit, like a biker suit with a real close tight fitting. You know what it looks like? It looks like the guys off of Tron, the Tron remake. Do you see that?
I did.
It's like a super slick. Tight fitting suit with a helmet on it that has sensors in it, and it probably it's a little stiff because it's got power running through it that gives it all the protection that it's got.
Yeah. Right. Okay. Does Eagle have any more power supply?
Pretty much what you do is you can plug that into anything. So like basically you can plug it into the outlet of the either the bike or the or the Explorer, and probably in a couple hours. And he charges like a cell phone, pretty much.
Cool. Yep. That works.
And like I said, it's not real super high tech, and it probably looks a little worn because none of them match.
No.
Like it probably looks like he got them from like police departments all over the planet. You know, So there's probably like a yellow one and a blue one and a green one. And, they're not all matching, and they're probably like a little frayed on the edges and stuff like that. But they still work fine.
All right.
And like I said, with a law level this high, I mean, not even blades are like, not even ownership is, you're not even allowed to even own them. On the colony worlds. But again, when you get outside the cities, there's no law here. There's physically no one to enforce it. So pretty much if you were back in the city, you do want to stash all that stuff. You'll be able to get it in. I mean, they're not checking or anything, but they have such a police presence. If you guys broke into a gunfight on the street, there'd be cops and grab vehicles like all over you, like in minutes. with like densitometers scanning, like basically like X-ray vision, sensors, like looking through the walls and all that. And I mean, they would get you. But once you leave the city, all bets are off. And of course, out in space and there's a bunch of other, this is the major planet, this solar system. There's like a dozen or 20 other planets in this, solar system anyway. So anything outside of that is great.
Okay, cool.
Okay, so Crazy Igor tries super hard to get everybody to slap ass drunk.
Not me.
Nope, yeah. I got work to do. I gotta put a laser on my butt.
There is tons of food. He even lets you use the tools for free. He probably even throws a mech bot your way to help you if you want to do that, because now you guys have given him 60,000 credits. he's probably drinking and saying, "Man, I love you guys. Man, I love you. I love you. I love you. I love you."
It has to be attachable and detachable as well. I want to fire it from my shoulder, but.
He's got an added manufacturing machine, much like the ones you guys got. So he'll a mech bottle, like scan all that and print something, it'll be like done in a couple hours kind of thing. And print that up for you and like tack it on your bike, however you can imagine it fitting on there. Like I said, it's about bazooka size. It's almost 10 kilograms. It's pretty heavy.
Yeah.
Big block.
And maybe we should test fire something.
So
make sure they work as intended.
Okay, he's unless there is some things that you guys don't want to discuss. So I will say this: everybody who has had their hands on the Union tablet. He doesn't know about it, but he knows that the Noah's Boistov had done a job. And he assumes you guys kind of looted that place out a little bit, and he's curious about what you guys found. As big and friendly of a guy that he is, I will say that, like Jerry sort of discovered with the bartering, he's pretty sharp, and the guy's probably walking around with a psychology degree or something. I mean, like he's definitely asking you some questions and trying to get you in little double entendres and all that. But he's trying to get everything he can out of you because he doesn't know you guys. So I will say probably Omen, the Doctor, and Darwin probably need to roll some sort of social standing save. I would say your social standing, if you have any kind of carousing or sort of interpersonal skill.
Rico, I think, is my closest.
If you don't, I'll let you use your determination. So your determination number, you should have that on your character sheet somewhere.
Yeah. The only thing I've got close to that is streetwise.
I got housing one.
Okay. If you don't have a skill to put in there, then use your determination. So basically, your determination is those two skills added together and use them like an attribute. So you divide them by five. I always forget which two they are. I think it's endurance and intelligence. That's what you use in case you ever do a task that fails. For you to try it again, you gotta roll determination. I wish forget which two.
Okay, so social standing and mine would be streetwise.
Okay,
intelligence, endurance.
Intelligence, endurance. Yeah, that's what I thought. Intelligence, endurance. So your intelligence, endurance, add together, divided by five. If you want to use that determination instead, and I'll say
intelligence and endurance.
And I'm gonna. That's a plus three. I am gonna make a
plus threes.
Two dice, two d six. Your target is six. I'm just gonna make it a random number you gotta beat. Beat a six of three, you guys, or you find yourself slipping up. And I wouldn't say you won't say, oh yeah, we got this tablet, but he'll know you got something pretty important.
Mm-hmm. Can we use JOT?
So it seems like a pretty low number. I'll let you JOT that, yeah, because you can like. Yeah, so I mean, you could re-roll that if you miss it with if you got
changed. My endurance and intelligence.
Mine's 11.
Divided by five.
Divided by five is four. You still gonna let me use that?
If you want to use that in place of your attribute and your skill.
Well, apart from streetwise, can I use streetwise?
That replaces all that. So if you use determination, your attribute and your skill.
Oh no, that's all right. I'll go plus two with the social skill, social standing, and
okay.
Streetwise. So.
Yep, I rolled low. All right, doctor.
All right, so I've got 18. So divided by four, right?
Yep.
So that'd be four.
Well, five. Excuse me, five. Five. Divided by five.
Oh, you're gonna round up. Okay.
Oh shit.
Whoa. Okay. Okay. All right. So he said he's. You know, he's like throwing food and booze to you guys and trying to get your life stories and trying to find everything else out about you guys. He probably puts on some like space porn.
Yeah, we can see Omen's. I know, not Omen's.
And he's probably got screens. So again, since it's at this point, this tech level with hollow screens and whatnot, basically all the walls and all the surfaces can become screens. So it's like, there's sex going on the ceiling, sex going on each wall, and music everywhere. It's all like, because once again, for the new guys, Justin and Jerry, one thing that they're all hungry for is, like culture from Earth. Because, again, they were all astronauts that basically came. There weren't tons of like artists and musicians and stuff like that. And also because the journey took so long, a lot of that information, like their data storage, started to fail. So a lot of things physically got lost. So things like, all the old styles from Earth, all the old music, all that kind of stuff, people are like hungry for it and they pay a lot of money for it. And there's some music out there that like the crews have basically like, like protest music has basically kind of been outlawed. There's some things they don't even want you even listening to. So of course that brings like big money. So MP3s and whatever stuff like that, popular culture from old Earth, people pay like big time money for. So that's why you're gonna see, even though this is like crazy in the future, dudes walking around.
Wouldn't new musicians though have aroused over the?
Oh yeah, well, yes, there are some, but and so what you're finding is a lot of them are copying you know, what
whatever fragments they had left of Earth.
What fragments they had left.
They don't have. They don't have any cultural background. I guess,
right. They don't have a lot of stories of their own yet. Right. So that's why you know it's like the 40-something century, but you're listening to like 70s music right now. You know, you're like, he's got some smooth Captain and Tennille going on or something. You know? And back at the Dostoevsky station, they've got like, you know, old consoles of Joust. You know, that they've remade, you know, and people play and stuff, you know. So anyway, so there's all kinds of stuff going on. I mean, music, booze, etc. And that's pretty much how the night's gonna go. So if you have a hankering to get trash and watch lots of Russian porn, it is there to be had.
I'm laying low. I'm not drinking a lot. I've ate a few things. I'm just kind of hanging out, and I'm using my intelligence and my carousing skill. I've got carousing too, to just be social, and I'm kind of sizing him up.
Okay.
Trying to see if I can read what he's really up to, but being friendly at the same time.
Gotcha. Okay. So, you know, there aren't. It is on way out. So, besides about the dozen or so people and the robots and stuff going around. I mean, you probably see like maybe one or two girls that are like, you know, mechanics or people that look like his guards or whatever. But formally, he doesn't have any entertainment here, you know, in human form. He does say he flies people out for parties, and he tells he's got like a whole. He says, upstairs, man, I got this whole dance floor, you know, in places. I get the bands in. It's crazy, man, because we can do all kinds of drugs. We can do all kinds of things that aren't allowed in the cities. It's just banging here, just banging. So he talks about all that. I imagine there's probably femme apparati.
Not the full body. You
know, I'm sure they're probably, you know.
There are probably things like that.
They're probably one in every shower.
you got to use a lot of imagination, I imagine.
Well, you know, there's three beds, right? So, you know.
And it is plastered on the wall now.
Maybe not, you know. So, and he does, you know, like show you guys, like there's another place. Now, I will say, again, as friendly as he is, and there's not even a role needed for this, if you're doing any kind of observation at all, as nice as he is, as open and as, you know, airy as this room and all that is, you totally know there's a air of security. So like all the doors are like blast door looking doors, you know, and
yeah, it's like partying with a Nigerian prince.
Right.
And again, one bad move and your head is gone.
Right. And again, the outside of this place was about a 7-story castle, pretty much, with like metal walls and, you know, sensors and things and all kinds of weird antenna and crap coming out of it. I mean, does he have a rapid pulse plasma gun on the roof? Probably. you know, I mean, the guy's got for real military hardware. He's for real established, you know, and you can tell he's insanely rich, thanks to people like you. And he's got, you know, and he does, but he is, like I said, kind of a survivalist where he's, you know, he's not ever going to have a husband or a wife. He's doing his own thing. You know, he lives outside on his own. I mean, he's kind of your crazy survivalist. You know, that's also an arms dealer. and from my bad Russian acting so far, you can tell he's way full of himself and narcissist and probably and maybe a little nutty, you know, because probably some of the most out there stories he tells you, people who've gone awry of him, he'll tell you how he like blew their whole like complex up and mowed them all down and all that. He's laughing about it the whole time, you know. I mean, he's talking about how people pop, you know, like when they get hit by a plasma charge, you know, how they just like pop right in half and it makes this sound. He's like trying to make it with his with his fingers and clicking and stuff, you know. And he's just happy as can be telling you about him, like, dread killing, like, a lot of people. So, you know. But he's...
It was like a melon.
You know, I mean, you know, he's crazy Igor. So, other than that, if there's anything more nefarious you guys are interested in, or you would like to accomplish, we can pull the curtains on this episode.
Sounds good. I want to buy spray paint.
Are you going to keep going every fourth or every two, every other Friday?
Yeah.
Good, because that's my schedule right now. You've lined up with me.
Okay.
So I'm in.
Hope it doesn't go out of alignment then.
If it goes out of alignment, it goes out of alignment. You NPC my character, and I'll drop in with... We've done some Cepheus Engine in between. I mean,